Hey, what's going on, guys? So today I wanted to show you how to use reinforcement learning with some financial data, time series data. Goal is to train an agent to decide when to buy and sell. That's basically it. So by the end of this video, you should have a pretty good format for what kind of steps you can walk through to achieve a training agent. Let's just go ahead, jump into the computer, and I'll get us started. So the first thing you're going to need to do is install Baselines 3 and any trading gem from OpenAI. You'll also need Tensorflow. So those are the three dependencies that you'll need to install. I've already installed them here. The next thing you're going to need to do is import your gem stuff. So gem any trading, then your reinforcement learning packages from stable baselines, dummy vector environment, as well as A2C. For this model, we're using the A2C model, but stable baselines has a bunch of different ones like PPO and DQN. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I'll link to stable baselines 3 so you can take a look at it. And then we're also going to need NumPy, pandas, and matplotlib so we can plot the stock data. Next step is to source our data. I'm going to use Alpha Vantage. I have my key here, and this is the API function. We're going to do a time series for intraday. So at 5-minute intervals, let's do Apple stock. We're going to pass that into a data frame. So what we returned is a timestamp, open, high, low, close volume, which is the minimum amount of data that you need to train an agent. The next thing we want to do is make our timestamp the index. And there you go. You see how that works. And then also we're going to need to capitalize open, high, low, close and volume for later on when we start training it in OpenAI's gem environment. Let's just take a look at the shape there. So there's 100 rows and there's 5 columns, basically. As I was saying, later on when we split it, we're going to do a window size of splitting the data. It's not quite as similar as X-train, Y-train, all that good stuff, but you'll see here in the next code environment. So now we need to build our gem. And if you're unfamiliar with reinforcement learning, basically the way it works is very high level overview is you have your neural network, which in reinforcement learning terms is called an agent. And then you have a gem where that agent learns to do whatever it is that you're trying to get it to do. So in this instance, we're going to build a gem and we're going to pass through stock data through that gem, and our agent will be able to take that data and then explore the data, and we're going to set its reward and it's basically what it wants to avoid, its pain points, its reward, and that's how we'll train it. So that's a very high overview level of it, but at this point we need to build a gem for our agent to practice trading in. So coming back to our notebook, we're going to basically create an environment using OpenAI's gem, and we're going to use its stocks version 0. I think there are other ones, but in this instance, this is all we're going to use. Data frame is our data that we just pulled from Alpha Vantage. Frame bound is basically, let's set this down. Oops, why isn't this working? Let's set this to 80 and let's set this to like a 3. Frame bound refers to the training and the validation set. So the 3 is in reference to the starting point, and then 80 is where it'll go up to, all the data that it'll see in the environment that it's going to be trained on. So remember, we have 100 rows, so we're only going to train on 80 of those rows. And the window size needs to be at a minimum this first number here, because the window size is at any given point, it's how much of the data the agent's going to see in the environment. So for this instance, at 5-minute intervals, it's going to have a 15-minute window size, basically, in the day for our training. So let's build that. And then we're going to reset the environment. And we're basically going to test that the environment works. In this case, it's just going to take a bunch of random actions. There's no neural network here. It's just we're saying that the action in the action space is random, is basically what we're saying. And then we're going to output the end state reward, done info, all that good stuff. And then it's going to stop and we're going to graph it. So we're going to see to make sure that the environment works. And you can see here that the total profit was 0.7. So basically what that means is in this environment, we've lost money. And if we were to gain money, it would be like 1 point something or other, right? And you can just, and you can tell the total reward is negative 0.6. So obviously we did pretty bad. And this is our data curve here. Well, actually this is all random. So if we just made random actions in our data set, we would lose money. So our goal is to maybe try to find an agent that can do better than 0.7. So let's go ahead and train an agent now. So environment maker, lambda, gym make, this is basically what we did above. I'm going to set the window size and that to that, and let's set this to here. You can play around with these settings. That's what's nice. Before I made one and it just wasn't working very well. And then this is our actual reinforcement model here. It's A2C using an MLP policy. And then we're going to pass through our GM environment, verbose equals one. Total time steps is, I think this is like way too much actually, because it's going to be hard to really figure out where the best model ends. Like it can overfit in the model and it won't be as good. So I'm just going to take a zero off that and make it, what, that's 100,000 time steps. Still kind of a, let's just do 10,000 just for quickness purposes. I don't know if that will make the model worse or better. Something I'm going to do in the future is make a callback, which will save basically the model weights of the neural network. So, and it'll save the best version of that. So wherever the metrics that show that it's a good model, that's what it'll save. So that's a future video, but for right now, we're just gonna run it through 10,000 time steps. So let's go ahead and do that. This is going to take a while, so I'll be back after it's done doing its thing. Okay, so I'm back, and it's gone through its 10,000 time steps. I think I should have maybe left it at 100,000 because this trained extremely quickly, and it's going to be kind of hard to explain what these are, and to be honest, I don't have like an expert level understanding of these networks here, but I know for a lot of these, we want our policy loss. We want some of these to be as close to one as possible, like our explained variance. We want that to be pretty close to one. Now, right now it's at -4, so that's not the best. It'll fluctuate, obviously. But let's go ahead and just see what we can get out of this here. So let's test it. So we're going to remake our environment. This time we are going to do, let's do a little bit of overlap. So let's do like 60 and we'll run it through the rest of our training set and we'll set it to what it's used to saying, 3. And OBS is just the observation equals the environment reset. So let's reset this. I'm going to skip over OBS because when I was redoing this, I was getting a lot of errors. So I was redoing it. So let's, you know, it's just the observation. So this is a while loop. It's similar to what we did up here, right? Except this time for our action state, we're going to use our model on our observation, which is, you know, reset, which is our gym. And then it's going to print done, all that good stuff. Hopefully it works. It did, and let's plot it. And it's sold on everything. I honestly can't really explain what I'm looking at here. It's telling me the total profit is one, which means we broke even, maybe, is what it's saying. Which could make sense, like we're losing money on these kind of bets here. But weirdly enough, we actually made money in the opposite directions. So like for all, basically what we did here is canceled all of our trades out, which is better than a loss. But let's see if we train it for a little bit longer, we could maybe get a graph that makes more sense here. Okay, so we've changed. We went from, so our first model, we did 10,000 time steps. And when we ran it through, we broke even. But it only made short trades. It wanted to sell everything that we had. And we retrained it on 100,000. So let's run it through again and see if we get any better results this time. It looks like we didn't break even. We actually lost a little bit. It performed better than our random because it's 0.9. But let's see what it looks like. Hopefully it'll give us more interesting graphs. Yeah, okay, so it did some buying trades, which is what I wanted it to do. At the end here of our data that we're pulling, this is Apple stock, by the way. This is the price on the y-axis. And these are like the steps. So this is 0 to 10 data rows, which would be 50 minutes, I guess, because it's a 5-minute interval. So it very well did buy. It bought here, sold up here. You know, those are good. Bought low, sold high. It sold down here. I don't know why it would do something like that. It probably should have bought at that point. And then it also bought up here. So those two trades were not doing good. Although it started out strong, it got flip-flopped around. But as you can see, you know, maybe with some more fine tuning, the other great thing about this is we can actually code in our own custom indicators. So right now it's using just indicators that it's learning from up and down, right? But we're not passing through any kind of like MACD, RSI. So in a future video coming up, that's what I want to do. I want to add in some custom indicators. I want to create a callback function so we're not saving the model at the end of its time steps, because sometimes it can overfit or it can, you know, just not be the best neural networks that we've gone through. So I want to create a callback function to save those weights. I also want to import more than 100 rows of data. It'd be nice to get, you know, a lot more on an intraday. So I'm going to look into that. And then I also want to just try out DQN and PPO models. Maybe there's something better than the A2C. But as you can see, this is a really powerful tool that allows you to basically trade. And it's a lot less complicated than, you know, coding out your own LSTM or something like that. But, and you still get the benefits of using an LSTM model as well. So that's also something that's very cool because of our policy that we set up here. Please, you know, if you're interested in this, I definitely wouldn't put this into production. Obviously, you know, we test it, it lost money in this iteration. So still lots of improvements that we can make, but I thought it would be really interesting. I'll let me know in the comments if, you know, if there's other improvements you think I can make to this model. And I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Bye.